So how are these millionaires stacking dollars on dollars exactly? What is the core reason that despite working intensely hard, the average working human cannot make that much money? Well, it's not about how hard you work, it's about how smart you work. It's no surprise the more income sources you have, the more money you tend to make. Welcome to Dollars and Bills. Research shows that 60% of millionaires have more than three sources of income, and more than 40% of millionaires have four different streams of income. And that is not all. The top 25% has more than five different streams of additional income, at least. Now that might get the IRS interested. You guessed it right. Today we're going to discuss the best methods to generate side income, which are going to cost you absolutely nothing out of your pocket. Selling what you already own on Facebook, eBay, or Craigslist. Now, many people can argue that this requires people to own something in the first place. But it is safe to say that almost all of us have at least something under our belts which we do not use anymore, and it is sitting in the closet eating dust. If that's the case, why not sell it and make money instead? Those are the perfect items which can help you generate some passive income, and at least it can bring something in your pocket. This strategy can help you replace old and outdated items and bring in quality items. Platforms like Facebook, eBay, and Craigslist can make it extremely easy for you to list all those items which you don't use anymore, and your total time commitment is going to be taking pictures and posting them on these websites with a suitable and catchy description. And what's the harm if they don't sell? You are losing nothing, and you actually get to keep what you already have. Simple as that. A counter-argument can be made that it is not a stable source of income, and if you keep on selling, soon you'll be alone in your apartment. You can clear a lot of clutter and make room for a lot of activities, and it is a great way to generate some quick money. Learn a skill and then monetize. We've all listened to some millionaires at least once in our life explaining how their skill set was helpful, and how learning new skills can be helpful in generating some passive income. If you can learn some skill, let's say you're good at video editing, graphic design, or any type of content creating, then you can monetize your skill set. Start finding potential employers or companies which can hire you or make use of your skill set. It will not only help you generate some money, but it will also polish your skills in the long run. Today, the internet is full of ideas. We can learn anything if we're serious about it. Websites, sales scripts, emails, or anything else. Or take NFTs for instance. Once you're good at art, consider making NFTs. We all know about that 12-year-old who earned more than $200,000 by simply creating an NFT. If you're good at a thing, or anything, there are bright chances that someone out there is looking for your services and is willing to pay you for your help. It really just depends on what you're good at. And once you develop a skill, it can go a long way in helping you generate some dollars. Earning through churning credit cards. Credit card churning is the practice of repeatedly opening new credit cards to earn sign-up bonuses and then typically stopping use of them. It can be a great way of earning some extra dollars here and there. This is going to demand some money spending from your side, and some people might object to it, but at the end of the day, you're spending money one way or another. For example, the Bank of America credit card is going to pay you a hefty bonus of $200 if you spend $1,000 in the first place. And to be honest, this is free money because they demand no annual fee whatsoever. Now, many credit card issuers offer attractive bonuses for people looking for their services. They are either doing it for their advertisement or they're doing it to compete with other banks or companies. It is a good and an easy way of earning a stable income. Everyone likes to earn from home by doing zero hard work whatsoever. Interestingly, you have the freedom to stop using the card whenever you want. If you applied for a card that had an attractive sign-up bonus but lackluster rewards for everyday spending, you're not stuck with it. You can always switch back to using other cards. Credit card churning involves frequently getting hold of new credit cards, not necessarily to use or even keep them, but rather to take advantage of lucrative sign-up or welcome bonuses in the form of cash or rewards miles or points. By opening many cards, you can rack up a significant number of miles or points or a hefty sum of bonus within a short period. As such, the strategy can be rewarding for savvy credit card users, albeit risky for the average consumer. In recent years, credit card issuers have put practices in place that limit churning. Focus groups. For anyone who's not familiar with what this is or how they work, focus groups are actually discussion groups where people group together and participate in a discussion about a product before it is actually launched in the market. This is done for feedback about, let's say, a product which a company has just recently formulated. Companies want your opinion on their upcoming projects and services. This is done by numerous companies so that when they step in the market, they already know what the customers want, and this helps them to better understand the demand in the market. If the companies can get unbiased opinions on what they're making, they can work on the areas they lack and produce better products by evaluation. So the question remains, how long it takes, what are the pay scales, and is it online? For the first part, it actually varies from enterprise to enterprise. And why would anyone mind to put in some extra hours to make that extra bit of fortune? The pay scales depend on how long you choose to work and whether you are consistent or not. Now, it's quite obvious that you're not going to see Elon Musk sign up for one of these, but if you want to make a quick $100 to $600, then this can provide you with a great platform. You can Google focus groups in your area and you can start hustling for your extra dollars today. Start a part-time job. This is probably the best and the most authentic way of generating some side income. It is a great way of earning those dollars which can help you in the hour of need. Traditionally, whenever we think about generating some side income, part-time work is the first thing which comes to our mind. It is important to understand that it does not have to be glamorous or extremely high in income. Of course, it will come at a certain cost. That can be in the form of extra hours, more work, but at the end of the day, it's going to be you who's earning those extra dollars. You can check out LinkedIn, Craigslist, and Monster for part-time jobs. You can ask around at your workplace for available part-time jobs. So many companies out there are looking for customer service representatives, data entry positions, and vacant spots in call centers. These opportunities are perfect for generating side income. There's no shame in working for these jobs, and if you're willing to work for extra money, this is one of the simplest ways to do it. Now, if you don't really have the leverage of spare time on working days, you can always look out for jobs on the weekends. Flipping items for free online. Now let's talk about a side hustle that almost anyone can pursue online. There is a lot of good stuff out there on some websites that you can get your hands on for free. For example, go to Craigslist and under the for sale option, click on the free bar and you'll see that there is a lot of good stuff available out there which people are willing to give away for free. If you manage to find any objects which can create profit for you, you can simply buy it. Let's just say that you find a lamp on Craigslist for $10. It is more than likely that the same object can be sold for $50 after some time. Hard work and consistency are the key aspects in this game. The more hours you're willing to put in, the greater is the chance for you to earn a hefty profit. If you want a $0 side hustle, which can help you earn big, flipping items online should be your go-to method. Most of the time, you'll see objects that are worth nothing, but if you put in those long hours, you can find that diamond in the rough. All you need to do is grab your camera and take good pictures, and then advertise it on Facebook or eBay to sell it on profit. What do you think about these methods of generating side income? Which one are you going to go for? Let us know in the comment section below. That was all for today. Please press the like and subscribe button so that you stay updated about all the latest happenings on our channel. Everyone wants to live a life free of financial barricades and constrictions, right? Long-term financial goals can sometimes seem tiring, and truth be told, not everyone likes these strategies. But what if you can start off small and gradually grow towards your goal of achieving financial independence? Welcome to Dollars and Bills, where we teach you about financial freedom. Why is it important to achieve financial freedom? Achieving financial independence means that you need to find more ways to earn your additional income. Whether it's a lucrative side hustle, or finding a second job, or investing wisely, going after financial independence will offer you a safety net that not every employee can offer. The key idea behind financial independence is being mindful about your spending habits and cutting off those impulsive expenses. Spending on unnecessary things is the biggest obstacle in your journey to financial independence. Moreover, pursuing financial independence can become a source for your learning of new skills. You cannot always live on your father's credit card, right? You cannot live a life where you need to think before buying even a mere handful of candies. One in every three American citizens has $0 saved for retirement. Breaking these financial shackles is essential for long-term financial success. And for that, saving money and using it at the right time is a pertinent step towards success. To put it simply, you need to take the matters of your life in your own hands. It might seem tiring for college and high school students, but we are going to make it super easy for you to live a life with comfort and joy. Before starting off, the first question which pops up in mind is when and how can we start? Starting a side hustle or learning a new skill. The best possible way to start your own business or to become your own boss is to start your side hustle and start your own self-employed income while you still have the safety and security of your day job. Starting a side hustle will not only pad your income, but it also creates career-changing opportunities you wouldn't have normally stumbled upon at your full-time job. Many side hustles have led to new jobs. It should be understood that everyone has a limited amount of time apart from the daytime job. One thing is for sure, it is going to take ruthless prioritization, a psychological shift in how you view your life, and the willingness to get very creative and scrappy on a daily basis. Now, many people can argue that they cannot manage a side hustle along with their education, or they want to focus single-mindedly on their college degree. Attaining an additional source of income does not mean that you need to skip college, but it means that you'll need to work for twice as many hours as you were earlier. If you want it, you need to go get it. Financial independence is not necessarily what everyone strives for. People have become used to working under different sources. They don't think of pursuing financial independence. There may be something you have always dreamed about, something you are passionate about, something you think can lead to a stable income for you. It's that first step that is hard. Once you're in the game, the cash starts to flow for you. Financial freedom can become a source for you learning new, innovative skills. It is not only a way of living a carefree life, but it can also lead to creativity and management. Something that can provide and equip young people with a decisive advantage over their peers. All you have to do is take some hours out of your everyday routine and start thinking about something that you have substantial grip on. It can be freelancing, it can start with saving money, it can start with a side job or anything. It can even start with a dollar in your hand. You need to reevaluate your priorities. One thing is for sure, that it is absolutely fun to not care about your financial goals and to carry on living on your father's credit card. But it's not going to be long when you will need to find a way to establish your own source of income. You need to start off by reevaluating your priorities. To do this, you have to establish your why. Do you want to be financially independent so that you can quit your 9-to-5 and enjoy life while you can? Do you want to be able to retire much earlier than the average person? Do you want to be able to buy your dream home? Financial independence can mean different things to different people, and establishing what it means to you is the first step to aligning your actions with your goals. That brings us to another important factor. Save as much money as you possibly can. When you don't have money, it becomes a source of a lot of pain, depression, and envy. Simple as that. In order to achieve financial independence, you must save money and always try to live below your means. How early you are going to achieve financial freedom depends on these two factors: how much money you spend and how much money you save. Just do the calculations and you can see how long it is going to take you to achieve your financial freedom. For example, if you spend 100% of your income, well, then you're never going to retire, because you'll never have the financial security to do so. But if you start saving, let's say 25% of your income, and you habitualize to live with certain restraints, then you can save much more, and that will ultimately open you to the option of retiring early. If you're saving 25% of your income, you're going to be able to retire within 32 years. If you're saving 50% of your income, you're going to be able to retire within 17 years, and the circle goes on. The bottom line remains the same. The more you save, the better you live. Cutting back your expenses. Life will be a lot simpler for you if you learn to live under certain rules for a small portion of your life. Cutting back your expenses can mean that you need to spend wisely. You don't want to buy everything that provides you with a dose of instant gratification. Don't spend your money buying things that you're not even going to use. This does not mean that you need to cut down your necessities, but what this means is that stop buying expedient things. Things which don't have any core value in your life and are not aligned with your goals. Firstly, you need to keep track of your spending habits. Try to calculate the minimal budget for all the basic necessities. You can and should also try to stretch your dollar out at the grocery store. Don't let your dollar run out cheap. Make it count. Create an emergency fund. Emergency funds can help you a long way in your journey to financial freedom. Try saving some dollars and start putting them in an emergency fund. This fund does not mean that you can spend this on parties, clubs, and beers. Make sure that you know what an emergency is. The money can only be used in dire circumstances. Let's just say that your car breaks down and you're running low on money, or your life has become completely derailed. That's when you will use your emergency fund. Instead of borrowing money from your family or friends again, you can always revert back to your emergency fund. Emergency funds can help you out of a tough situation. So put some dollars in that fund and you'll never regret this decision of yours. Another way to safeguard your savings is to buy something that you think will protect your money. Take real estate, for instance. Simply try buying some property, and if that miserable time comes upon you, you can always revert back to making money by this asset of yours. Not only that, but you will observe that your money will grow over time. Investing can also be a beneficial way for your financial growth. Try investing your savings or look to double it up. Investing is a great way to save and secure your money if you know how to go about it. It can go a long way in stabilizing you financially by securing profits for you. For example, you have saved more than $10,000 in a year. Instead of just waiting to spend them and wasting them, try throwing your money into the market after you spend a good couple of months studying the market. It's quite simple, to be honest. The companies you will invest in will provide you with a stable income, and this can help you in growing over time. Investing does not require you to get bound. It simply means that you need to invest your money and then start working on your everyday life. By the time you have started to save money again, you will observe that the companies you invested in are coming back with big stacks of profits. But the bottom line remains the same. You cannot go investing blindly. It can also lead to a disaster in the shape of your money drowning in the market. So seek understanding of the market before opting for investing. So how are you planning to go about your journey into financial independence? Let us know in the comments section below. According to research, more than 60% of adults do not have enough money saved up to cover a $1,000 emergency. Are you tired of borrowing money to pay for your unexpected expenses? Or are you fed up with the inflation rates taking a heavy toll on your pocket? Either way, you're exactly where you need to be. Welcome to Dollars and Bills. We all know that the world is going through an extreme surge of inflation. This wave is taking a huge toll on the pockets of the working class, and saving money is a great way to counterattack this devastating wave. Saving money can go a long way in equipping you during your toughest of times, and it acts as a source of security for you. Who doesn't like money in the hour of need? Here are some important tips which can help you save a lot of money in a short span of time. Buy it tomorrow instead of today. Now, this technique can go a long way in helping you save money, and it works every time. Try it when you go shopping, or if you're just out visiting a grocery store. It's our natural instinct to get attracted to a particular thing when we first see it. But research proves it, that when you give it a second thought, when you think again, your mind opens you up to a much deeper and realistic image. It's all about cutting down those impulsive purchases that can haunt you down towards the back end of the month. Research also proves that shopping actually releases a large amount of dopamine, or the sensation of happiness. And if we go even deeper down the rabbit hole, we can find out that we get happier with the anticipation of buying something instead of actually buying something. This can help you a long way in saving money and growing financially. Just don't buy it then and there. Instead, just sleep on it and try giving your brain another chance to think about it. This can help you save a large amount of money in a very short period of time. So buy it tomorrow instead of today. Would you rather have the cash? Imagine that you're standing in a superstore thinking about buying something. Now think if you'd rather like the cash in your hand for the same thing from someone. Would you rather just have the cash? If your mind responds with a nod, then that thing is surely not the thing to be bought. Sometimes we actually forget how much the thing costs when we're so fixated on buying something. But try thinking to yourself, would you like to be paid the same amount of cash? The amount that you're willing to buy this item for? Let's just say that you see a very attractive car, but to buy that, you have to go beyond your financial limits. Ask yourself, would you rather have the cash in your hand from someone else? Or do you want to sink your money buying that car? It really gets you prioritizing about what's important and what's worth your money. It really helps you think more on the aspect of saving money instead of spending money. It can also make you think about the long-term financial goals and would that purchase be feasible or not. If you actually divide the things you bought and the amount of money you paid for them, you can end up demanding your money back for the majority of those things. How many hours does it cost? The majority of us are people working 8 to 10 hours in offices and working hard to make a living for themselves. We all have duties and responsibilities. Before you decide to sink your money and buy something useless, ask yourself if you're willing to put in the same number of hours which allowed you to make this money. Simply, how many hours does it cost? This can force your brain to go deep into the rabbit hole and can often open you up to the deeper realities. For example, if you're making $20 an hour and you decide to spend $60 on dinner, then you'll have to work for an extra 3 hours. Or going and spending an equivalent of $20 on a lunch break is the same as you working an extra hour at work trying to earn that $20 you spent. The same lunch break could have been utilized with $10 instead of spending $20. Basically, we all have a very limited amount of time on this planet, and it is up to us to make the most of it one way or another. Not only from financial standpoints, but also from personal fulfillment. We need to spend our precious time and money on the things that are the most important to us. Simply don't waste your time, money, and hard work on things that don't have any long-term value. Simple as that. Sometimes when you consider how long you'll have to work to earn those dollars back, you might not waste it and end up saving a huge amount of money. It really makes you reconsider whether or not that thing is worth buying in the first place or not. It's a lot easier to spend your money buying something than coming back and working those extra hours in the office. Become more mindful about where you spend more money and simply draw the comparison in your mind. Don't keep a huge amount of money with you. Save your savings. Don't just find ways to spend your hard-earned savings. One way of saving your savings is to transfer the money in some other account. This will create a feeling in your mind that you don't have a lot of cash on you and you can't afford to buy every other thing you see in the superstore. Research proves that the more cash we take with ourselves, the greater is the possibility that we find silly ways to spend that cash away in a blink of an eye. This can also help by creating a sensation in your mind about your growing bank account. This can teach you many things, to be honest. When you see your bank account growing, it will render savings effective in your mind, and ultimately, you'll start to save even more. For example, when you spend $10 on lunch instead of $20, you save those $10. Now go ahead and transfer those $10 in a bank account so that the amount you saved remains saved. Now here comes the real deal. Apply this phenomenon to every single one of your expenses and see the magic happen. You'll observe that over time, you have saved a lot, and now you always have something to bounce back on during your hours of need and emergency. When you observe this, you'll simply see your savings add up over time. Once you get used to this practice, you're going to be really excited about seeing that extra money around. Find ways to multiply your sources of income. Saving money is fun, but wait until you get familiarized with the art of multiplying it. Additional sources of income means that now you don't have to be dependent on a singular source of income to manage all of your expenses. Instead, now you can run an extra mile and you can expand financially. When you have money saved up, by the time it can grow into bigger sums, and that's the time when you really need to grow. You need to upgrade your money and give it wings. One such way can be investing. Another interesting method to save your savings is to invest in real estate or simply buy some property. This can safeguard your interests, and by the time when you're in need of some serious money, you can always revert back to this asset for quick money. Chances are high that by the time you reach this property, it can provide you with an extra $100,000 or so. Take investing. If you save up, let's say, $10,000 annually and throw it into the market or real estate, you will get a stable profit over time. Now, what if you keep on reinvesting your profits? That's where the fun starts. The world is riddled with people who started slow, but eventually they saved huge sums and used investing as their ladder to financial prosperity. Now, some may argue that investing in stocks is full of risks, and that is the truth, to be honest. But provided that you have done appropriate research and you have spent a quality month or two doing your homework about investing, it's more than likely that you will shine at some stage. Another way can be of simply putting in extra hours in a side hustle and growing over time. This can create additional sources of income for you, and by the time you really start to get in the game, you'll see your savings going up. Think of what your money is going to be amounting to in the future. What is going to be its future value? If you just keep on saving those $20 and invest it over the next 40 years, think of your future position. That was all for today. Make sure you press the like and subscribe button for more interesting videos. So what do you think about these saving strategies? How are you planning to save your money? Are you going to multiply your sources of income, or are you going to stick with your savings? One way or another, saving money is essential for long-term financial success. Let us know in the comment section below.